Hello everybody, here to talk to you about something I've done for the Phantom FC40. I've seen this question asked on the internet a lot as I've been browsing myself, looking for upgrades and stuff. And the question that is asked is there a way to boost the range of the camera on the FC40? And the answer is yes, it's very doable. As the people who have this know, and some of you who don't know, obviously, that this little camera does all the work on the FC40. It is a wireless camera, so not only does it shoot the video while it's flying, it also streams video directly to your cell phone. It does not connect in any way, though, to the actual Phantom, so it's just, you know, a standalone device. So the wireless is not really powerful on it. So you can get out there, you know, like 300 feet, I'm assuming, somewhere around there, and the video starts to drop. So a lot of people, again, were asking, is there a way to boost that? And the answer is yes. So let me show you. This is what I did. I went out and I bought a, you know, standard off-the-shelf Wi-Fi Booster, and then I bought a external power supply. Comes like this. This one is a 3800 milliamp, and I just made sure that the volts and the amps were the same as what goes into the router here, or I should say Wi-Fi Booster, which is 12 volts, 1 amp, and that's exactly what this one does. And I will give links to these devices where you can get them, too. So after I did that, it's quite easy. You basically just set up the Wi-Fi booster to connect to the camera, and it'll boost the signal. Then you connect your phone to the router, or I keep saying router, sorry, the Wi-Fi booster. And in another video, I'll actually show you how to set this up. It's really not hard at all. It's actually very, very easy to do. But there is one trick you have to do to make it work, and that is when you turn on these cameras, it basically does a certain format for the naming, and the app that you use will only try to connect to that same format. So what I did is I kind of just tricked it by whatever the camera was named, whatever the number was at the end, I just added 1 to it. So it was a 0 at the end for the camera. I just added a 1 to the name of the router. So when I see that, I connect to that, and that way I make sure I'm actually connecting to the booster and not the camera itself. So to show you, I'm going to go ahead and turn this guy on, and I'll show you that it actually does work. So we're gonna let that guy light up, go through its startup process, put him back there. And again, I just used Velcro here to hook it to the back, so when I have it in the field, I can just set it where I want, but just plug it in here. Switch it on, the router turns on and boots up. And the camera's going. Let me go ahead and get my phone ready to attach to the camera. And it looks like everything's booted up. There's the app, and let's scan for it here. There it is. As you can see, it does a FC40 underscore, and then it goes, it encodes these numbers and letters by the what's called the MAC address of your camera. And all I did is change the 0 to a 1, so I know it's my Wi-Fi router, booster, excuse me again. And voila. There never seems to be a problem. This thing always connects. And in the short testing I've done, I've taken it out to 400, 500 feet, and I've still had signal. I have to do like I said more testing, but as you can see, we're getting the video no problem, so it works good. So I guess, you know, if people are out there wondering, as you can see here, the answer is yes, you can do it. And like I said, I will in the description put exactly what router this is and where you can get it and where you can get this battery pack. So I hope you enjoyed the video. If you do, please hit the like button. And for the heck of it, at the end, I will throw up a little bit of video that I did of the sunset I was shooting when I was testing out this booster today. So thanks for watching. Thank you.